Hi, I'm Lori.
I'm Carina.
And today we are at Build It Workspace, and we're going to talk about what a makerspace is and what to expect the first time you visit one.
Here at the Makerspace, I'm the main engineering consultant. My background is mechanical engineering and fashion design, so I can help people both with the technical and creative aspects of making stuff.
So now we're going to sit her down and we're going to grill her with a whole bunch of questions.
So a makerspace is a physical location for you to have access to tools and machines to take an idea from your mind to a physical object. Absolutely. Makerspaces become a hub, really, for people that have an idea in their head and are ready to go to the next level, but they don't necessarily know how. Everybody, just be curious. We've taught 8-year-olds how to do coding. We've taught 70-year-olds how to do 3D design. Generally, there's a couple different types of makerspaces. There's nonprofit, community-based makerspaces. You'll find makerspaces like this one that's a business location. And this one works by paying a monthly membership fee, and with that membership fee you have access to tools, machines, our knowledge, and space to make your projects. Makerspaces are extremely important for people to be able to have access to machines that they wouldn't have access to in their own homes. I find makerspaces to be places that you can come in and interact with other people of like mind. You can bounce ideas off each other. You start in one place and you end up in a completely different location, but it's probably 10 times more awesome than it was when you started. A networking environment also, and we host all kinds of events for people to do that specifically. We've hosted Society of Women Engineers, we hosted a quilting group, we hosted Boy Scouts. So we're purposely making it so that people come in and they talk, and not just to use the machines, but to develop ideas. For somebody who's never been to a makerspace, I would try and go if they have an open house event. We try and do show and tell events so that people can see not just the machines but what other people are making and how they're using the technology to make their projects. But if this is your first time to a makerspace, just take it in. Give yourself time. That's, I think, one of the biggest points is don't try to go to a makerspace when you only have 30 minutes. There's not much you're going to see in 30 minutes. Walk around. They're going to see the sights. Just come in relaxed. Come in curious. Talk to people. This is a social environment. It's made to be interactive. It depends on the makerspace. In this makerspace, we have quite a bit of technology. We have lasers, we have 3D printers, we have CNC machines. So you can learn the tech, you can learn the design aspects of it. We can go even more basic than that. We do have a lot of crafters. We hosted a quilting group. We have machines that you can cut fabric. You don't have to sit there and cut hundreds of squares. You can do it on a machine, and it will even draw seam lines for you. So crafters come in, we have jewelry makers, we have machines to do chocolate molds. You can do personalized chocolate molds. We've had projects from very low tech to very, very high tech. Come make stuff!
Yes!
Well, I want to put up there, just make it at this point. I was trying to get people interested in making things. And there's such a world of difference between people who make stuff and people who don't. And you don't know until you've made it. And it doesn't matter if it's a crocheted blanket. It doesn't matter if it's cards. Or if it's robotics, it's the same thought process. You just need to make it. You want to feel comfortable. If you're not comfortable, you're not going to be as creative. Initially, you may be a little intimidated by the technology. Try and ignore the technology initially. Just get a feel for the space. See if you like the people that are there. See if you like the way it's laid out. Ask questions about tools. Besides, just the 3D printers and the lasers. Ask about basic things. Do you have rulers? Do you have pencils? Go for the utility things that you know that you're going to need.
So last but not least, we want to say thank you to Carina for hosting us today and answering all of our questions about what it's like for your first time in a makerspace and what it is and what to expect. And we were talking about it earlier, and they have a bunch of different pieces of equipment, including...
We have CNC, we have lasers, we have 3D printers, all kinds of different machines for you to make all kinds of different projects.
So check out the website. We're going to link it below. Take a look at the equipment they have. Let us know what you would like to see in the comments, and we'll come back and we'll actually feature whatever piece of equipment is the most popular and do a video on how to use it and basically what the specs on it are. And if you are in the area, which is generally...
Long Beach, Los Alamitos.
Stop by the Build It Workspace, and if you aren't here, consider taking a trip to your local makerspace. You can probably find it online, and on the website, there's actually a place where you can put in your zip code and find one that's near you. So for this week, it's Lori from Maker High signing off, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!
Bye!
Green is good.
Okay.
I'm just, you're walking out of frame! Now you're not in frame.
Go back to the beginning.
Back to the tape.